now for my report. Grooved stones, utyushki, bearers or mur, or transverse grooved artifacts, in short, TGA, comprise a category of grooved items which include small, non-abrasive, heat-resistant stone or ceramic specimens, varying in shape, quality and decoration. They are bearing transverse groove or grooves of semicircular section and interpreted as shaft strafings. The extent of the spread of these artifacts in Northern Africa, Southern Europe and Northern Eurasia in hundreds explain their interest to their investigation for the informational potential as indicators of their culture intersections. The analysis of a large collection of TGA, more than 500 items from different regions, resulted in the following conclusions. Transverse stones of Northern Eurasia, Southern Asia and the Near East have some common features. I will mention here those that are relevant to the studied in the title topic. The TGA are diverse in morphology and decoration. The second, at least 50% in the Middle East and more than 80% in the North Eurasia have an artificial shape. About 50% of TGA in Eurasia are decorated. The percentage of decoration reaches 80% at certain territories, for example in Siberia. Each territory has its own marker in morphology or decor. For example, the Ukraine transverse incisions along the perimeter, convex top and convex bottom, triangular and T-drop shapes reach around the groove, and so on. Natufian culture, pedestal shape, Zagros, transverse incisions on the bottom of the groove. The Ural, board-shaped items with cut ends, grid ornament, animated strip along the long axis, narrow forms, and so on. The same elements of the decor or shape can be found in remote areas. For example, tree-like or maybe scorpion-like decor known on the TGA of Syria, Turkey, Ukraine, the Ural, Trans-Ural, Siberia. Zigzag or serpentine maybe ornament known on the TGA of Syria, Turkey, Ukraine, the Ural, Trans-Ural, Siberia, Kazakhstan. Mapping of TGA with the same decor or morphology makes it possible to trace their prevalence. For example, longitudinal groove on the bottom, transverse incisions on the bottom of the groove, single, double or triple lines incisions on the both sides of the groove, grid on the face, sides or bottom of TGA. A high degree of identity of certain varieties of decor and shape does not allow considering such facts as an occasion. Since morphology and decor is considered to be cultural indicators, it is logical to assume that tracing the chronological sequence in such groups of TGA sites, we will be able to identify identify at least the vectors of spread of interactions as at maximum the spread of traditions. According to the literature review, one can confidently state that the introduction of TGAs is generally linked to the epipaleolithic on the eastern, northeastern coasts of the Mediterranean Sea and differently associated with the hunter and gods. The place, date, and provenance of this movement remains unclear. The data tend to favor the southern Levant or central Anatolia. The latest data obtained at Anatolian site Elvat Terrace in Levant places the earliest examples to no later than the middle of the 13th millennium Cal BC. The grave 13th at Pinarbazi in Anatolia either predates the early Natufian, shows the end of the 13th Cal BC. By the 11th millennium, TGA occupies all the territory of fertile Crescent and Anatolian plateau. The area of TGA occurrence in Near East is surrounded with hard natural barriers. Mediterranean Sea in the west, Arabian Desert in the south, Zagros Mountain in the east, and the Croatian Highlands in the north. By the end of the 9th millennium BC, TGA, a few and sparse in that period, appeared in southern Europe, eastern Asia, and by the end of the 10th millennium BC, almost along the entire southern edge of northern Eurasia, from the northern coasts of Black Sea region to the foothills and oases of Central Asia, including mountain, plateau, and coastal zone of Caucasus. How many ways existed from the Near East region to Northern Eurasia and Southern Europe, and how they were distributed in time, it is impossible to say now. Of course, a similar linear algorithm of distribution from the Near East is not applicable because the intersection of the highlands can be carried out in various ways, as it is seen in the example of Silk Road or network of modern roads. The existence of numerous paths is also marked and proved not only by the large number of mountain passes, but the areas of emergence of early TGA along the southern border of northern Eurasia. Look here. These territories and this one. Several such zones are known and quite removed from each other. Sometimes they are separated by formidable obstacles. Just natural barriers such as mountain chains or a desert help to localize some path similar to a cone. What is especially important, grooved stones, each of these zones were presented with their own decorative and morphological types. Every such area has given rise to a separate transit flow, marking at least the direction of interaction as a maximum tracing the movement of a certain groups of bearer of a particular cultural tradition. For example, TGA with longitudinal grooves on the bottom Oi, sorry. Like on the bottom are three like decor, grid, etc. If you take into consideration the scale of the phenomenon marked by TGA, it becomes obvious that the search and cartography of TGA's finding is a very important task. Some very expensive kinds of TGA don't have analogues in the border zone of the foothills, but have them directly in the Middle East. These are the northern coasts of Mediterranean, Black and Azov Sea. I guess this fact, and especially island Cyprus, not only shows the directions of the distribution, but simultaneously allows us to raise this view of habitat navigation no later than in 9th millennium Calvi Sea in this section of Mediterranean. Conclusion. Last TGA show themselves an expressive and perspective markers of vectors of cultural interaction extended in time and space. The preliminary outline of the directions of interaction on the ground of TGA's shape and decor is as follows. The interval of TGA existence covers the period nearby 10,000 years at all. Areal, all steep and semi-desert territories of the Mediterranean Sea coast, the Caspian culture in Northern Africa, the Levant, the Anatolia, the south of Europe, plus the entire steep forest-steppe and half-deserted belt of Northern Eurasia from Moldova to Mongolia. Chronological analysis reveals that TGAs originated in southwestern Asia and then spread to different regions. Interesting results reveal the overcoming of the mountain, desert and water barriers. We have discovered that the spread of TGA has been carried out along different paths. Moreover, the growth stones along each of these transmissions roads are represented by their own decorative and morphological types. Obviously, every road has given rise to a separate transit flow indicating at least the direction of interaction and at best tracing the movement of particular cultural tradition. It is still unclear whether spread out of TGA was the dissemination of idea or carried out by carriers. But this is the prospect of further research. Genetic research, I hope, will provide a more accurate answer to this question. Thank you for your attention.
About the summary. Thank you.